Dear students, in my today's session, we will study about tribal Panchashila, other backward classes and their problems. Now, let us study what is tribal Panchashila. In my last class, we studied the three weaves of tribal welfare, that is, the weaves of the policy of isolation, second one, the policy of assimilation, and the third one, policy of integration. Of these three, the policy of integration occupied the best policy and would benefit for the tribal people of modern advanced society at retain their separate identity. The aim of this policy is developing a creative adjustment between tribes and non-tribes in India, leading a responsible partnership. This policy was supported by Jawaharlal Nehru, M.N. Srinivas, and Majumdar. How the partnership should be between tribes and non-tribes is explained with the help of tribal Panchashila. Now, Jawaharlal Nehru, in his forward note, tribal Panchashila, to Verrier notebook, Verrier Alvin's book, The Philosophy of Sneha, laid down the five important principles known as tribal Panchashila. They are, first one, we should avoid imposing anything on them. We should try to encourage their own arts and culture. Second one, tribal rights in their land and forest should be respected. Third one, a team of their own member, their own people, should be trained to take up the responsibility of their administration and development. To do this, some technical personnel is of outsider is required in the beginning. But too many outsiders should not introduce in the tribal territory. Fourth one, we should not introduce too many schemes in the tribal territory. We should rather work along with their social and cultural institution, not in rivalry. Fifth one, we should judge the results by the quality of human character, not by the statistics and the amount of money they spent. So these are the tribal Panchashila. Clear, student? Okay. Next, move on to other backward classes. It is also known as OBCs. It refers to socially, economically, culturally, educationally backward communities of backward castes rather than untouchables or rather than scheduled caste or the scheduled tribes. I repeat, other backward class refers to socially, educationally, economically, culturally backward communities or caste rather than scheduled caste or other than scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. This OBC comprises on non-untouchability, lower intermediary caste, and those who are engaged in traditional occupation like agriculture, animal husbandry, and handicrafts. Other backward classes are heterogeneous in category because there are many divisions in the overall category. Therefore, OBCs or other backward classes are not classes at all, but groups of communities. These other backward classes constitute 52% of total population. This is other backward classes. Clear? Next, problems of other backward classes or problems of OBCs. Under that first one, other backward class constitute an indefinite, abstract, and unorganized category. So why other backward class is indefinite? Why it is indefinite? Because the first backward class commission in 1953, that is Kalilkar Commission, contained 2,399 cast as OBCs. But it was rejected by the government, and the second commission was appointed, that is Mandal Commission, in 1979. It contains 3,743 caste as backward classes, under backward classes. But the number is not definite. So that is why OBCs are indefinite. Okay? And OBCs are abstract. Why other backward classes are abstract? Because the members of other backward classes are stranger to one another. And they do not have any awareness regarding their own problems. It would result conflict between them regarding the issue of backwardness. And next, OBCs are unorganized category. In unorganized category, they do not have All India level organization. All OBCs are scattered all over the India. So this is the first problem. Clear? The second one, economic backwardness. A large number of other backward classes suffering economic problem. A large number of them are poor, unemployed, underemployed. Only a few of them are self-employed. So this is second problem. And the third one, educational and social backwardness. A large number of people are illiterate in this category. Educated people are very less. Even though they are not directly the victims of untouchability, but there is social distance prevails among between the OBCs and forward caste. So this is third one, social, educational and social backwardness. Their literacy rate is very low and educated people also very low. So this is educational problem. Next, political unorganized. OBC or other backward classes, they are not able to work, pressure any politically pressure category. because they constitute, they comprise a single caste. No single caste of backward class is numerically dominated in any state or the region. So this is politically unorganized. These are the problems of backward class people. Clear? Next one, criteria of backwardness, that is Kalelkar and Mandal Commission. There are two backward class commission in India, constituted by Government of India. The first one, Kalelkar Commission, and second one, Mandal Commission. The first backward class commission, formed in 1953 under the chairmanship of Kaka Saheb Kalelkar. This commission submitted the report on 1956. In this report contains list of 2,399 castes as other backward classes, and it contained 70% of total population. This criteria adopted the awareness of backwardness are: first one, low social position in the caste, traditional caste hierarchy of Hindu society. Second one, inadequate or non-representation in governmental services. Third one, inadequate and representation in the field of trade, commerce and industry. But this Kalelkar Commission was not accepted by the government because it contains 70% of total population. Then government appointed second commission, that is Mandal Commission, under the chairmanship of B.P. Mandal in the year 1979. This commission list 3,743 castes as backward classes. The criteria adopted to determine the backwardness are social criteria, educational criteria, and economic criteria. Social criteria, social backwardness is considered by others. Second one, marriage of 25% of girls, 10% of boys in rural areas, 10% of girls and 5% of boys in urban area below 17 years. Third one, female work participation is 25% above state average. So this is social criteria. Clear? Next, educational criteria. Children, the age of 5 and 15 were not attending the school, 25% of above state average. School dropout rate is 25% above state average. Matriculation pass is 25% below state average. So this is educational criteria. Third one, economic criteria. The value of family assets below 25% of below state average. People are living in kaccha houses, 25% of above state average. Third one, the sources of drinking water beyond 500 meters are the 50% of more than 50% of the families. So this is economic criteria. Clear? Social, educational and economic criteria. The weightage of these criteria was not same. That is, 3 points for each social criteria, 2 points each for educational criteria, and 1 point each for economic criteria. So it came out 22 points. Any caste are getting more than 11 points are considered backward classes, other backward classes. This criteria recommended by Mandal Commission was widely applied even today to determine the relative backwardness of the community. According to Mandal Commission, it recommends 27% of reservation for other backward classes. Government directs to implement this and refer to Supreme Court. In 1992, Supreme Court gave the judgment, that is, it accepted 27% reservation for other backward classes. And it directs some changes in the policy. They are, first one, creamy layer exclude from any type of reservation. Creamy layer people are excluded from any type of reservation. Second changes, the reservation policy is not applicable for armed forces, pilots, university professors and scientists. The reservation quota to all the category such as scheduled caste, scheduled tribe and other backward classes, that is not beyond to 50%. That is, for the reservation for scheduled caste is 15.5%. Scheduled tribes is 7.5%, and the reservation for other backward class is 27%. Clear? So this is criteria of backwardness, Kalelkar and Mandal Commission. Clear, student? Next, creamy layer. So what is creamy layer? It was introduced by Santanam Commission in 1971. It refers to a relatively wealthier and better educated members of the other backward community. They belong to other backward class, but they are not get any benefit. They are not get any reservation, or they are not get any benefit from the government sponsored educational and professional fields. Even though they belong to other backward class, but they are not getting the benefit. In the creamy layer, according to Santanam Commission in 1971, directed the creamy layer directed creamy layer people are excluded in the reservation of armed forces and services granted by the government or granted to the OBCs. The people belonging to creamy layers are like engineers, doctors, chartered accountant, and professors, lawyers, and so on. Their annual income is more than 8 lakhs. However, the political forces like Prime Minister, Chief Minister, Governor, MLAs, MPs, or MLCs are not included in the creamy layer. So this is creamy layer. Clear, student? Next. The last part of this chapter, that is Karnataka State Backward Class Commission and overview of Karnataka State Backward Class Commission. In that, Karnataka State Backward Class Commission in pre-independent period and Karnataka State Backward Class Commission in the post-independent period. Okay? In pre-independent period, that time that was only one commission, Miller Commission, formed in 1918. And the post-independent period, the Backward Class Commission in Karnataka, the post-independent period, there are four Backward Class Commission, that is Naganagowda Commission, Havanuru Commission, Venkata Swami Commission, Chinnappa Reddy Commission. These are the four commission of Karnataka State Class Backward Class Commission. Clear? First one, Naganagowda Commission. Naganagowda Commission was formed in the year 1960 under the chairmanship of Naganagowda. It submitted the report at 1961. This commission recommends the reservation for scheduled caste is 15%, reservation for scheduled tribes is 3%, and for OBC is 50%. So total it contains 68% of total population. Government wanted to implement this and referred to the, it was stayed in the Supreme Court. Finally, in 1963, government gave an order, it guarantees for scheduled caste 15%, for scheduled tribes 3%, and for 30% for other 30% reservation for other backward classes. So this is the first commission, that is Naganagowda Commission. So Karnataka State Backward Class Commission, first one, Naganagowda. Clear? The second one, Havanuru Commission. This was formed in the year 1972 under the chairmanship of Havanuru. It gave report on, submitted on 1975. It contains more than 50%, up to 50% reservation for other backward classes people. It contains up to 50% reservation for other backward class, and it contains 75% of total population. But government directed to change it to give 58% of reservation and challenged in Supreme Court. Finally, government report to the court to stating that to initiate new commission. And the third one, Venkata Swami Commission. It was formed in the year 1983. And this commission submitted the report on 1986. According to this commission, it recommended for reservation for scheduled caste is 15%, reservation for scheduled tribes is 3%, and for other backward classes, the reservation for other backward classes is 27%. But this report was not satisfied because it did not include Vakkaligas and Lingayas. That is why government did not implement this commission. The last one, Chinnappa Reddy Commission. It started on 1990. government appointed the Chinnappa Reddy Commission on 1990. It recommends 15% reservation for scheduled caste, 3% for reservation for scheduled tribes, and 32% reservation for backward classes people. This was widely accepted, welcomed by all, to seem to have tried the best to uphold social justice. So this is Chinnappa Reddy Commission. Clear, student? So these are the Karnataka State Backward Class Commission. After the independence, the four backward Karnataka State Backward Class Commissions are Naganagowda, Havanuru, Venkata Swami, and Chinnappa Reddy Commission. Clear? In the last part, that is Permanent Backward Class Commission. Based on Mandal Commission, Supreme Court decided to establish Permanent Backward Class Commission in central level, state level, and union territories. According to this, Karnataka government set up the Permanent Backward Class Commission under the chairmanship of first one, Narayan Rao, in the year 1994 to 1997, and then second one, Ravi Kumar, 1997 to 2000, Muniraju, 2001 to 2003, Siddhalinga, 2003 to 2006, Dwarakanath, 2007 to 2010, Shankarappa, 2011 to 2013, and finally Kantaraju, 2014 till date. He is the present chairman of Karnataka Permanent Backward Class Commission. He is the present chairman of Permanent Backward Class Commission. Clear? This Permanent Backward Class Commission recommended for any inclusion or exclusion of caste in the backward class list. At present, in Karnataka, there are 101 scheduled caste and 51 scheduled tribes respectively. Clear? Now, let us summarize in what we studied in today's session. First, tribal Panchashila. This is important question for 5 marks, 5 important principles. And they can also ask for 1 mark, who advocated the policy of tribal Panchashila? Answer is Jawaharlal Nehru. This question can be asked for 1 mark. And 5 marks question is, explain the tribal Panchashila. Clear? Next, other backward classes, it refers to economically, socially, culturally, educationally backward caste other than scheduled caste and scheduled tribes. The problems of backward classes, that is, backward class constitute an indefinite, abstract, unorganized category. Economic backwardness, educational and social backwardness, and finally, politically unorganized. Next, criteria of backwardness. There are 2 backward commission in India, important for 2 marks question. Answer is Kaka Saheb Kalelkar Commission, first one, and second one, B.P. Mandal Commission. And for 1 mark, they can also ask for 1 mark, who was the chairman of first backward class commission in India? answer is Kaka Saheb Kalelkar Commission. Kalelkar was the chairman of first commission in India. Clear? And the three criteria of backwardness, name the three criteria of backwardness. This is also important question for 2 mark. The three criteria is social criteria. I already explained the 3 points, social criteria. And in the 3 point, the first one, social backwardness considered by others. Second one, marriage of 25% of girls, 10% of boys in rural area, and 10% of girls and 5% of boys in urban area below the 17 years. Okay. Third one, third social criteria of third one, female work participation is 25% above the state average. Clear? Second, educational criteria. There are 3 points. First one, children of 5 and 15 years were not attending 25% of attending the school, 25% of above state average. And second one, school dropout rate is 25% of above state average. And the third one, matriculation rate was 25% of below state average. This is second criteria. Third one, economic criteria. In that three, first one, the value of family assets 25% below state average. Second one, people are living in kaccha houses 25% of above state average. And the third one, sources of drinking water beyond 500 meters is beyond beyond 500 meters of up to 50% of the families. It is more than 50% of the families. So this is economic criteria. Clear? So name the three criteria of backwardness: social criteria, educational criteria, and economic criteria. Okay. So this question can be asked for 2 mark, and also the criteria of backwardness, that is this question is important for 5 mark also, that is social, educational, as well as economical criteria. Clear? Next, what is creamy layer? This is important for 2 marks question. Important question for 2 mark. It refers to a relatively wealthier and better educated members of the backward classes. Clear? Next, Karnataka State Backward Class Commission. So after the independence, there are 4 backward class commission in Karnataka, that is Naganagowda, Havanuru, Venkata Swami, and Chinnappa Reddy. This question is also important for 5 marks, and overview of Karnataka State Backward Class Commission. Okay, that is Naganagowda Commission. The first and foremost commission was Naganagowda. This is also important for 1 mark, which is the first commission in backward class commission in Karnataka, Naganagowda. Okay, and the second Havanuru, third one Venkata Swami, fourth one Chinnappa Reddy. Clear? Next, the present permanent backward class commission chairman is Kantaraju. Who is the present chairman of permanent backward class commission? Answer is Kantaraju. This is also important for 1 mark. Clear, student? So these are the other backward classes in India and the Karnataka State Backward Class Commission. Clear? Thank you.